seeing out there this morning?
We sure do. So I'm standing specifically at East 144th Avenue at York and Washington. So this is the area that's closed down. This is in Thornton. Thornton police shutting down this road because of the flooding you see behind me. I'll step out of the way because this umbrella is so big it blocks everything. But you can see just how deep this water is. I only waded a few inches in, and I would say it was already up to my ankles, just off to the side of the road right here. So in the middle, it's pretty deep. And I do want to point out that this is not the only closure in this area. So again, this area specifically is 144th between Washington and York. For some reason, where we're sitting, this area is closed off, but there's no sign on the other side of this flood blocking off that side of the road. So we have seen some cars risking it all to drive on through. We took video of some of these cars, some of them really speeding through this area, bringing those plumes of water, you know, up on both sides of the car. It's been pretty interesting to watch. So far, no one has been flooded, but they are driving in the middle of the road as opposed to the areas off to the sides. So York Street is also closed between E470 and East 156th Avenue, and then between York Street and Colorado Boulevard. So lots of flooding in this area. I was talking earlier about how just 6 inches of water can reach the bottom of most passenger cars. And hey, here's a big SUV driving through as we speak. Look at all that water. Ooh, we have a bus, an RTD bus, risking it all too right now. And those SUVs, about 2 feet of water is when it becomes a problem for those vehicles. But you just have to be really careful. A foot on average is going to be a problem for most of the smaller sedans. So in areas like this, the best advice is to turn around, don't drown. I would not follow the advice of these cars, though those seemed fine. So just a heads up if you're driving in this area, East 144th Avenue is closed here in Thornton. We'll keep you posted throughout the morning to see if and when this rain stops and if this is able to dry up. Reporting live, I'm Kristen Chapman for Daybreak on 2.
Crazy to watch all that happen, and they have to swerve over across the double yellow to even get through there. You'd think that when they would close it, they would actually physically do a better job of closing it, so it's not so easy for the cars to drive around. Kristen, be safe out there. I know your water boots go all the way up to your knees. I saw them this morning. So rain shower.